most recent Sunday, I woke up early before my brunch shift. I got in my car and I drove to Streeterville, downtown Chicago, and picked up a music stand from Facebook Marketplace for free. On my way, I saw a man smoking a cigarette, reading the stickers put on one of those blue curbside mailboxes as intently as you'd expect someone to read the morning paper. Deep focus. Deep inhale of the smoke. Morning, young women going to get Bloody Marys, eggs over easy. And when I finally pulled up to the apartment building that this man from Facebook lived in, I got out of the car and I went inside and let the doorman know why I was there. And he buzzed him down. This man finally got downstairs to deliver the music stand. He asked me if I was a musician, and I told him that I was. He asked me what I played, and I told him guitar, and that I sang and songwrite. And he didn't seem very impressed, and he told me as he handed it over that the music stand belonged to a very famous man. And I asked him who it was. And he gave me a name that I've already forgotten. There was someone to do with the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. And I remember the word president being used. I messaged him on Facebook again a day or two ago, asking him what the name was, again, of the man whose music stand I now have in the backseat of my car. Paul hasn't responded. Nice to wake up early, and it was nice to be on the streets of Chicago before most of the other people are even awake, and to watch the sunrise from my kitchen window, to beat the traffic, and to do something with my day more than just crawling out of my bed before clocking into work. With the windows down before winter sets in. So I'm grateful to Paul on Facebook Marketplace, and I'm grateful to the man whose name that I can't remember.